Recently, guys, I've been editing in DaVinci Resolve 18, and I have to say I've been enjoying DaVinci Resolve 18 way more than Premiere Pro. Now, I know there's been a lot of creators, a lot of filmmakers and people on YouTube, videographers, whatever. A lot of guys have been switching over to DaVinci Resolve as of recent. And I'm not gonna lie, I've had DaVinci Resolve for over 2 years now on my computer. I just never really wanted to dive in, but with the influx of people switching over to Resolve, it just kind of renewed my interest. Some of my videographer filmmaker friends use DaVinci Resolve, so I was like, why not? Let me hop back in. But this is not a video about me switching over to Resolve. I am actually gonna have a video talking about my transition over to DaVinci Resolve from Premiere Pro. I'm still using both, but learning DaVinci Resolve has been a main task for me lately. But in this video, I just wanna quickly tackle one thing that I think a lot of people, especially if they're new to DaVinci Resolve, or if you're moving from Premiere Pro, from Final Cut, or if you use all three, if you use both, and you're just trying to look for a quicker workflow for your color grading, this is gonna be helpful, and that is copying your node trees or copying your power grades, as they call it in DaVinci, or just your color grades over to a new project. Being able to save them as a preset, that way you don't have to go and do the node tree all over again. It's super quick, very simple, but it took me a second to figure out, but I wanna show you guys just so you can carry that over into your next projects and make the process that much more seamless. All right, guys, so firstly, you know, obviously you want to open up a project, so I'm gonna bring you guys over into DaVinci right here. I have a project called color grading because I have been mostly practicing my color grading lately over in DaVinci Resolve. Now obviously what you want to do is you want to grab whatever clip from your media section, and you know, just for the sake of this video, it's not a super crazy thing to pull off. I'm gonna grab one of the clips I have down here. All right, so yep, we have that over here. As you guys can see, I shot this in log and vlog on the Panasonic S5. So I'm gonna bring you guys over to the color section. And just for the sake of the video, right? So we have our first node right here. I'm not really gonna add too much, but we can add a few different nodes just as an example. Let's quickly mess around with our primaries. You know, maybe we could bring lift down a little bit, bring our gamma up. I'm not doing this as a real grade, but I'm just showing you guys an example for the sake of the video. Obviously, if I was really grading this, you'd want to have this at a hero shot. That way, when you're, you know, when you're actually grading it, it's the best place to kind of get a feel for how it's going to look during the rest of the clip. But like I said, this is just to show you guys this quick little example. So I'll continue bringing my lift down a little bit. Oh, no, we're kind of all right there before we're touching zero. Move the gain down for sure. I think right there is good. Like I said, this doesn't have to be anything crazy. All right, so like I said, you know, this is not a real grade, it's just an example. So we touched it up a little bit. That's how it is before, after. Now if you, let's say this was a full-fledged color grade, guys, what you want to do is you want to go over to your screen, you want to right click, you want to hit grab still. Once you grab the still, it's gonna pop up in your still section. What I do is I move this, you take your screenshot 1.1.1 right there, drag it over to power grade. I don't think it has to be there, I just prefer it to be there, that way I know that I have a certain color grade in that place. And guys, that's literally it. Now let's take this clip for example, double click, and all of a sudden, boom, if this was a color grade, now we have that color grade on this clip and we didn't even have to do anything. And just to show you guys that it does work across projects, let's open up another project here, DaVinci Trials 1. Now guys, completely separate project, let's go over to an ungraded, untouched clip. Obviously, you know, you would want to touch things up if it was a real color grade, but once you're over in the power grade section, we do still have the 1.1, well now it's 1.1.2, but the grade from the last project is there. Double click, boom, your node tree is there and everything. Node tree is there. Look, we have everything from our primaries. It's all there. You know, we didn't touch the rest of this, but the whole node tree carried over. We can even reset this. Double click on it again, boom, whole node tree is there. The clip has been edited, and you can carry that from project to project. That way, if you guys create you know, a signature look with your node tree structure here, or a color grade that you wanna bring over to a new project, you don't have to go and recreate that every single time. Use your still, double click that, and it will carry that over. So Super quick tip, DaVinci Resolve has been fun, but I just wanted to bring that to you guys so you can see that and increase, you know, the speed and the fluidity of your workflow. I'm gonna have a lot more DaVinci Resolve tutorials coming out as I also learn the program. And actually, really quick, just if you guys were not aware, instead of copying your whole node tree structure, this is just if you wanted to copy a similar node tree structure from clip to clip, not from project to project. This is another way you can do it. Let's say, you know, we reset this grade right here on this clip. What you want to do is you want to select the clip that you want the new grade to be on. Say I wanted this color grade to be on this clip, right? So you want to click on that clip and you want to hit the scroll wheel on your mouse. So you want to actually hit the scroll wheel right here. You guys can see that. You want to click the scroll wheel on your mouse. Once you're on the clip that you want, boom, copies it right over onto the new clip. So that is just also another alternative to copy the node tree structure, but this is only within your project. The one that I showed you guys with grabbing the still, that could be from project to project. So hopefully that made sense. Hopefully I explained that pretty well. I've only had it in the full studio version for like about a week now, but I've been really diving in so I can learn it and perfect it. So I'll be sure to bring you guys along for the ride with that. So anyways, guys, if you guys did enjoy this video and if it did help you out, feel free to drop a like on the video. I greatly appreciate that. Make sure to subscribe as well, as I do a lot of filmmaking, storytelling, videography content, all types of stuff like this, tutorials, obviously. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Like I said, my name is Jason Morrison, guys. I hope to see you guys in the next video. Deuces.